This is the creature there has never been. They never knew it, and yet nonetheless, they loved the way it moved, its suppleness, its neck, its very gaze, mild and serene. Not there, because they loved it, it behaved as though it were. They always left some space, and in that clear, unpeopled space they saved, it lightly reared its head, with scarce a trace of not being there. They fed it, not with corn, but only with the possibility of being, and that was able to confer such strength. Its brow put forth a horn, one horn. Whitely, it stole up to a maid to be, within the silver mirror, and in her. How should we be able to forget those ancient myths that are at the beginning of all peoples? The myths about dragons that at the last moment turn into princesses. Perhaps all the dragons of our lives are princesses, who are only waiting to see us, once beautiful and brave. Perhaps everything terrible is, in its deepest being, something helpless that wants help from us. So you must not be frightened if a sadness rises up before you, larger than any you have ever seen. If a restiveness, like light and cloud shadows, passes over your hands and over all you do, you must think that something is happening with you, that life has not forgotten you, that it holds you in its hand. It will not let you fall. How shall I hold my soul, that it may not be touching yours? How shall I lift it then, above you, to where other things are waiting? Ah, gladly would I lodge it, all forgot, with some lost thing the dark is isolating, on some remote and silent spot that, when your depths vibrate, is not itself vibrating. You and me. All that lights upon us, though, brings us together, like a fiddle bow, drawing one voice from two strings, it glides along. Across what instrument have we been spanned? And what violinist holds us in his hand, oh, sweetest song? Earth has not anything to show more fair. Dull would he be of soul who could pass by a sight so touching in its majesty. This city now doth like a garment wear the beauty of the morning. Silent, bare, ships, towers, domes, theaters, and temples lie open unto the fields and to the sky. All bright and glittering in the smokeless air. Never did sun more beautifully steep in his first splendor, valley, rock, or hill. Ne'er saw I, never felt, a calm so deep. The river glideth at his own sweet will. Dear God, the very houses seem asleep, and all that mighty heart is lying still. Thank you.
Just look at me.
I'm limited. And just look at you. You can do all I couldn't do.
Good.